Yeah.
Stunt 101. Yeah.
My shoot y'all to stunt, my wrist stay rocked till my TVs pop up in the Maybach Benz. I shoot y'all to stunt, you can't see me, my Bentley GT got smoke gray tint. I shoot y'all to stunt, my neck stay blingin', my rims they gleamin', I'm shining, man. I shoot y'all to stunt, I see you scheming, you keep on dreaming, I hurt you, man. I shoot y'all to stunt,
7 series BM, 6 series Benz, 24 inches, Giovanni rims, yeah. R1, one wheel when I'm on one of them. Ma, that boy out there acting a fool, that's him. They say I changed, man, I'm getting paper, I'm flashy. They like me better when I'm f***ed up and ashy. My royalty checks, the rebirth for Liberace. Stunt so hard, everybody gotta watch me. And I don't really care if it's platinum or white gold. Long as it's BS bling, they got that light show. In the hood, they say 50, man, your sneaker look right, yo. Just can't believe Reebok did a deal with a psycho. Banks, this is your thing, y'all. Might blow. I'm finna drop that, so I suggest you really low. But keep them cash, bill 10 a key. Getting them 10 a key, save 10 for me.
I shoot y'all to stunt. My wrist stay rocked till my TVs pop up in the Maybach Benz. I shoot y'all to stunt. You can't see me, my Bentley GT got smoke gray tint. I shoot y'all to stunt. My neck stay blingin', my rims they gleamin', I'm shining, man. I shoot y'all to stunt. I see you scheming, you keep on dreaming, I hurt you, man. I shoot y'all to stunt.
Sensing a lot of tension now that I'm rapping, but the kids used to look up to you. What happened? Me on the contrary, hand covered with platinum. Different color coupes, but I'm in love with the black one. On point, cause you get RIPs when slacking. So the stash box big enough to squeeze the Mac. And yeah, I'm feeling new, but I demand some respect, cause I already wear your advance on my neck. I'm fresh off the jet, then I breeze to the beaches. Blue Yankee fitted, G-Unit sneakers. I already figured out what to do with all my features. Decorate the basement full of street sweepers. When it comes to stunting, there's nothing you can teach us. We're in a different time zone, your records don't reach us. Nah, I ain't here to save the world. Just roll up a... Come with me out front.
I shoot y'all to stunt. My wrist stay rocked till my TVs pop up in the Maybach Benz. I shoot y'all to stunt. You can't see me. My Bentley GT got smoke gray tint. I shoot y'all to stunt. My neck stay blingin', my rims they gleamin', I'm shining, man. I shoot y'all to stunt. I see you scheming, you keep on dreaming, I hurt you, man. I shoot y'all to stunt.
You don't have to like me in a throwback jersey with the throwback Nikes. I know you probably see me with cash money from back in the days. The only thing changes the numbers on the range. I bought me an old school and blew out the brain. The rock the mic tour, I threw off my chain. My spree well spinning, man, I'm doing my thing. And warden that trouble, now that you in the game. Come on now, we all know gold is getting old. The ice in my teeth keep the crystal cold. G-Unit, homie, acting like y'all don't know. Look, I can't even walk through the mall no more. I just pull up, get out, and get all the They never seen doors set up on a car before. Don't be mad at me, dog. It's all I know is how to show these fugazis how it's supposed to go.
I shoot y'all to stunt. My wrist stay rocked till my TVs pop up in the Maybach Benz. I shoot y'all to stunt. You can't see me. My Bentley GT got smoke gray tint. I shoot y'all to stunt. My neck stay blingin', my rims they gleamin', I'm shining, man. I shoot y'all to stunt. I see you scheming, you keep on dreaming, I hurt you, man. I shoot y'all to stunt.
What's the science? Yep. I am Jamaica. This is the Jamaica Code. You are live on the air right now. RMCOnAir.com, baby. We are talking about fitness. Fitness. You know what that is? You know what's really it was fitness. Do you know that? I'm gonna teach you something. I'm gonna teach you something today. You're gonna learn something today. It was fit in this. You know us. We know how to shorten shit. So we just call it fitness. Yo, what's the science, y'all? I'm here, man. We talking fitness. We talking easeplexity. I'm live, y'all. And you know, when I do it live, I do it live. All right? Guess what y'all did today? Y'all came to the livest show on the air. The dopest show on the air. The Jamaica Code. Now, first off, shout out to 50 for that, I'll teach you how to stunt, my rims say stop. See, my engineer, he's a youngster, see? And 50 is old school to him. 50 is like Grandmaster Flash is to me, to him. You know what I'm saying? So, shout out to 50 for that one, though, because that was the whole G-Unit right there. Minus Yayo, because, you know, Yayo was on the mission. But anyway, teach you how to stunt. So, he said, well, didn't he go bankrupt or something like that? Let me tell you something, man. You know, some companies just get so big that they just can't fail. You know what I mean? Depending on what it is. And he said, well, 50 ain't made a song in 5 years. 50 didn't have to make a song in 5 years. It's a difference. You know what I mean? It's a difference. You have to make a song in 5 years. You had cats that came out 5 years ago that had to make a song every 5 months. And you ain't heard shit from them since. You know what I mean? Bunch of them. You know what I mean? They got their catalog. You get your catalog together, you know. We're going to go off into my fitness thing in a minute. But let me get a quick analysis of the industry. Considering that I've trained everybody basically in every industry. From fitness to sports to movies to, you know, you got to be fit to do anything. You know what I mean? That's productive. So, that ain't no different from anything else. Anyway, make a long story short. That song is dope. Teach you how to stunt. I'll teach you how to stunt. I remember staying around. But anyway, so, he said, well, didn't 50 go bankrupt? 50 can't go bankrupt. It's impossible. Here's the reason why. If he didn't have so much sense, he could possibly go bankrupt, but even with all that money. You see what I'm saying? But you're talking about a very smart man, business-wise, very smart, extremely smart. Smarter than any other rapper, hands down, in the game. Yeah, I said it. Say something about it. Any other rapper, 50 smarter than any other rapper in the game. You know somebody that's smart? That's what I'm telling you. You know the only person smarter than 50? Possibly. Yayo. Tony Yayo. Why? Smartest rapper in it because he don't rap. Shit. That's my boy. We getting millions. If I want to rap, I rap. Other than that, I'm just going to roll and be quiet. You know what I mean? I'm telling you. Nah, there's plenty of people that can out-rap, yo. But you can't outsmart them. You feel me? Them is the two smartest people in the game. And you probably think, how did Tony Yayo get up there with 50 as one of the smartest people? Listen, man. If someone is following you around 24 hours a day and you just learning, you could be an old soul, you could be a youngster, you can be whatever. You got people that is, here's the reason why I say this. You got to be on point with certain things. Because at the end of the day, God got the final say, all right? So if you get shot 9 times and you get up and you spit the bullet out, and say, okay, what's next? What's next? You know what I'm saying? I like what 50 said, one of the coldest phrases ever. He said, before I got shot, I ain't give a fuck. You know what I mean? Period. But after I got shot, all them times, I really didn't give a fuck. So what do you do at that point? You go for what you know. But see, God deals with people in their extremities. See? Some people don't have to get shot 9 times. I mean, he grew up in the streets. Mother was killed, never met his father, this and that. I'm against all odds. That's when you go for what you know. Who gonna stop you at that point? What do you have to lose? See, I tell people all the time, I don't give a shit what it is. You can be a janitor, you can be the postman, you can be a jet fuel liner maker, you can be anything. But whatever you are appointed to do, you are anointed to do. Period. better than anybody on the planet Earth. We'll never know because there's somebody probably on the other side of the planet that can do the same shit you can, but you'll never meet them. Who cares? You know what I mean? Whatever you were appointed to do, you were anointed to do. And here's the good shit. If there was a good works that was started in you, whatever it is, whatever, once you find your purpose, whatever you, when you discover your purpose, like 50 discovered his purpose, but it don't start, you know, it start how it started. Tyrese started with a 20 second commercial on the, was it Pepsi, Coke? He walk on the bus singing. Now he doing Transformers and this and that and all this shit. He didn't sing one word. I don't believe, did he? No, he just said, do-do-do-do-do. He had his headphones on, do-do-do-do. Next thing you know, multimillionaire. But that was his purpose. You got to start there. Some people got to start with a whole album. Think about these things for a second, yo. What's the girl name? Fantasia. Was that her name, Fantasia? And you don't want me, then don't talk to me. You remember that song? The Sessing Entertainer said. That's how she sing it. If you don't want me, then don't talk to me. Hey! She was the last person to get to the what do you call that? That's the thing, man. American Idol. American Idol. Idol, right? American Idol? Yeah. They had closed the doors, every goddamn thing. She had caught the bus. Yeah, I mean, she was plane, trains, and automobiles. She was the last person to get there, y'all. The last person to sing him. She walked in there, she blew him away. Fate? Come on, man. Romans 8:28. All things work together for the good of those that love the Lord and is called according to his purpose. Please don't get me started, but that is the absolute truth. That means basically, if you're walking in your purpose, everything is going to work out, believe it or not. Did I just prophesy to you? I don't know. I ain't no damn prophet. I don't think. I like the prophet. You know what I mean? But either way, God chose me to do certain things. One of them is to change the world through fitness. All right? So I express my way how everybody else probably wouldn't. For example, I put men that work out don't date obese women. That's just what I put. I believe that. I believe men that take care of themselves. And I know obese women don't like to date obese men. Stop it. Stop it. You go to anyone, any obese woman's page or any Instagram, all this shit. Every man you see is going to have abs looking good, this and that. Ooh, ah, lick him. Ah. You don't see no big obese women like, yo, look at this big obese guy, y'all. Look at this dude right here. He just the same size as me and all this other shit. Stop it. That ain't what happens. It's just not what happens. So my thing is, when I say something that's real, I'm a bully. I say some real shit. You ain't gonna never see nobody. You ain't gonna never see no Ben Affleck or you know, one of these Hollywood dudes on the red carpet with some big, huge, obese chick, unless... Here you go with pressure. She had to get her ass in here some type of way, didn't she? You never see a Ben Affleck with a Precious on the red carpet, yo. Never. But let me get back to what I was saying. Close that, yeah. It just don't happen. So people will reply and say, well, I know this one couple. Well, goddamn, one in a million? We talking about the majority. I'm talking about the majority here, y'all. I'm not talking about the minority. I'm not talking about one in a million. Anybody can strike gold if you're supposed to be where the gold is. Alright? Now, but here's the thing. That is my fact. I didn't say it was nobody else's fact. It's my goddamn fact. Take it how you want it. People can complain and they say, yo, well, everybody's not, you know, everybody that's small is not healthy. I absolutely agree. Absolutely. But that is not the point. The point is, how unhealthy are you? See? I'm not, my show is not about bulimia and, what's that other shit? Anorexia. That's not what my show is about. My show is about obesity. Fat. Baby. So that's what I talk about. You know what I mean? You want to talk about some obesity? They got about 150,000 other shows probably on the internet. You know, blogs and things like that. All right? But this show, as for me and my household, we going to talk about getting this fat up out the joint. All right? Now, let me see what we're talking about here today. Shout out to, back to what we, like, before I go, before I even finish this, let's get back to 50 in the bankruptcy thing, all right?
I was gonna let you go.
Nah, can't let me go with that, because listen, when you got that much money, you got that much sense, failure's not an option. You know what I mean? Failure's not an option, you know? Okay, now, if a person that don't got no money goes bankrupt, guess what? They got 7 years bad credit, that's it. Give a fuck, go to the next of the slide, boom. Bible say that, low the poor will always be with you. You know what I mean? But when a person like 50 go bankrupt, that's just saying I'll pay you when I get feeling I feel like paying you. You know what I mean? It don't got nothing to do with, oh, I ain't got no money. It's what? I owe you what? See, it's an ego thing at this point. He got to pay, you know, he got to pay some people that day. He lost a couple big lawsuits to. I know he lost a Sleek for like $17 million. Then he got to pay this chick, Officer William Roberts, baby mama, $5 million for some sex tape. You feel me? He's just like, man, I ain't paying you shit. I ain't got no money. Where your money at, Phil? I ain't got no money. No, we know $50, at least $100. I know, you know what I mean? You gotta have at least $100 when you're doing that much. But here's the thing, though. A lot of people don't understand this. A lot of people can be rich by association. See? You got a bunch of rappers, but they can't call, you know, people to, you can't call film directors and all. You got a bunch of rappers. 50 can call Oprah. I don't know what the fuck they may talk about. You never know, because he named his goddamn dog Oprah. You know what I mean? But good. That was a smart move, 50. And she still interviewed him. You know what I mean? But see, it's about associations. You see? But that, when people were talking about hip-hop industry, it's such a small thing because there's only a few people on top. Yeah, they got music here, there. You got people that's playing music and that. But like you said, 50 ain't made a song in 5 years. He ain't had to make a song in 5 years. But I guarantee you, in 5 years, he didn't never stop making money. I'm talking about this. It's been a good 10-year run of not falling off. Starting with the Vita Water. Coca-Cola bought that for, what, $1.4 billion or something like that? Coca-Cola bought that. 50 owned 12% of that company. See, the thing is, I study everybody that is successful. I don't give a damn. It's from Russell Simmons to Bill Gates to anybody. You know what I mean? It's a certain level that you're going to be on if you study the successful levels that other people are on, that you have that same, you know, that same knowledge, you know what I mean? It's a powerful move. So anyway, to make a long story short, no, him and Floyd ain't in the class, and he's saying, yo, Floyd, what chapter are you on? Chapter 11. Got him back with that. Floyd got more money than 50. You know what I mean? Floyd don't do no endorsements. Well, you ain't who he endorsed. See? If Floyd did endorsements, his shit would go up to another, at least, man, you got people that's trying to, you know, you got people that want to, you know. The thing is, what happens after you retire? And I know this is off the mark a little bit, but we don't want to see Pacquiao and Mayweather too. Fuck Pacquiao. Fuck all that. We don't want to hear that. I don't care about that shit. You know what I mean? And I said it. Yeah, tell Pacquiao I said it. I don't want to hear about that shit. All right? You know what I mean? You did all of that, Bob, and you know, yeah, you do. You, that was a sparring match for Floyd, man. You didn't do nothing that made me say, oh, man, if next time I swear, nothing. It was none of that. Well, you don't deserve another fight with Floyd Mayweather, period, point blank. And you don't deserve $160 million for that? That was a sparring match. It's a walk in the park. All that shit, all that hype. Now your shoulder hurting. You should want a rematch. Man, fuck all that. You ain't getting no rematch. We don't want no rematch. I'm down with the Money Team. Money Team, I'm down with you. Don't get this clown another goddamn fight. Period. You got me? Now, got me on one this Friday morning, y'all. How y'all feeling this morning, y'all? You know what I mean? Y'all drinking your alkaline water? Y'all staying hydrated? Fortunately, this summer hasn't been as hot as it normally is. But then again, I don't know where the fuck y'all at. Y'all may be in Mississippi. Shout out to all my peoples all around the world, wherever y'all at. You know what I mean? Shout out to my people in Chicago. You know y'all over there shooting. Y'all stay cool now. You know what I mean? I notice when the weather get a little trippy, y'all turn it up a little bit. Stop that, y'all. I'm praying for y'all, all right? Y'all some important people out there. You know what I mean? If y'all made it a big standoff and change, guess all the other youth and all that'll make a difference too. All right, now, Donald punk ass Trump. Donald Trump, check it out. Give me a suite at the Trump Towers, Vegas, for a lifetime, with a free butler, maid, and chauffeur. You get my goddamn vote. You feel me? You got to give me all of that shit first. It got to be in writing. All right, I'm gonna give you my vote. My vote. All right. Your ass ain't gonna win because you're too stupid. You can be smart. You can be the smart. You can have all the wisdom in the world, but no knowledge. You know what I mean? I'll give you an example. A doctor that smoked cigarettes. You know what I mean? Got all the knowledge in the world of what the fuck a cigarette can do to you, but no wisdom to say, I don't want to be a part of it. You get what I'm saying to you? That's what this exchange is. All right, let me get a room. I'm a suite. Sorry, presidential suite. I want the same shit you stay at when you were down, and I need that for a lifetime. And you only gonna get my vote, just my vote. All right, that mean that you ain't gonna win, but I'm gonna win. You know what I mean? I'm gonna win. I'm gonna be saying that the Trump shit while you just mad because man, why I get dude? So you ain't that tough. Bet me. All right. Who else we got here? Caitlyn! Do I gotta go to break before I go in on Caitlyn? Huh? Mm-hmm. What the fuck, yo? Let's have a moment of silence for this bullshit. Gotta be some bullshit. Arthur Ashe, humanitarian. You know what he did for the whole culture of black people? This man was a historian, someone who made a difference in the world. A real champion, might I say. And Brucey gets up here. Brucey. Did you see it? What'd you think, man? Nah, that's all you can do is just shake your head. Just what the fuck? Like, who does this? Like, here's the thing. I don't give a fuck if you turn in from a man to a goddamn monster. I don't care if you turn into, what's that thing they can't catch? The chupacabra Bigfoot. Thing, whatever it is. What it is?
Bigfoot?
Not Bigfoot. Fuck Bigfoot, too. Fuck it, I don't give a shit. Who?
Chewbacca?
The Chewbacca, not the little thing that they're, I don't know what they call it, a little Latino thing. I think it's called the chupacabra, capa chupa, the chupacabra, something like that, yo. I don't care if he turned into that. You know what I mean? Why give him the Arthur Ashe? That's just another slap in the face to us. But we used to it. Because they stood there and they gave him a standing ovation. Did you see that? Did you see that shit?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, fuck it. Courageous.
If you was in the crowd, you wouldn't have stood up?
Fuck no, I wouldn't have stood up.
Front row,
I don't give a shit. I don't care. I'd have been just like this. I'd have been just like this. That would have been one of the times. I ain't never on no social media like that. That would have been one of the times I'd have been on Twitter. Like, look at this bullshit right here, man. You know what I mean? See, the thing about what I do is, no one can stop what I say. I'm uncensored. You see what I mean? So I can say the fuck I want to say. It don't affect nothing I do. Nothing. I'm a messenger. Touch not my anointing and do my prophet no harm. The steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord. So, no, I'm not going to sit there like, yeah, I mean, I'm not going to jump up. I ain't going to Kanye him, you know what I mean? Like, yo, let me tell you something. This shit is some bullshit. You know what I mean? Beyonce had the best. No, I ain't going to do that, you know what I mean? But I'm going to do this. I'm going to sit there like, you motherfuckers is crazy, yo. I'm not finna stay get this clown no standing fucking ovation. For what? Think about this shit for a second. Everybody gonna be calling me about this show today. Because this is the show I'm just going in. Who the fuck does that? Think about this for a second. If that was a black man that won gold medals and was on the Wheaties box, let's just give an example. Michael Jordan. He just decided he's 55. You know what? I'm 6'6". I want some tits and ass. And I just... Do you think that the ESPYs would have given him the goddamn Tom Landry Award or some type of John Wooden Award, lifetime coach? Get the fuck out of here, yo. I'm going in. I just don't get it. Bruce, Caitlin, whoever the fuck you are, give all that shit back. The medals, give all that shit. Do like Lance Armstrong, you know what I mean? This is what you do, Bruce. Give all the medals and shit back, and since you wanted to make a big difference and you think you're a better person now, let Caitlin win the motherfuckers back, yo. How about that? How about that, Bruce? All right? Give all that shit back, your Wheaties box. They took Reggie Bush shit back. You know what I mean? They took Marion Jones shit back. They sent her to jail. Goddamn, for what? They sent Marion Jones to jail. They should send Bruce ass to jail. You know what I mean? Yeah. You want to make a big difference? You want to change lives? There's a bunch of transgenders in jail. Go in there. Change your motherfucking lives. You got the nerve to stand up there and get this long, boring, dull ass speech. It got everybody looking at you. Did you see the people facing the audience? They was looking in her. They was horrific. They was like, oh, they was showing motherfuckers. They was like, oh, God, look at this motherfucker. Oh, shit, you should see the eyes. I'm like, damn.
I got a question.
What?
You know what that reminded me of?
What?
I know it's one of the greats, but from man to almost woman looking, Michael Jackson, though.
Huh?
Defend Michael Jackson.
Michael Jackson, he listen, man.
Think about the young Mike and then what he was a few years
ago. Mike had,
what's the difference?
Billy Lago. His skin was, you know.
Wasn't he becoming more womanly looking, though, throughout time? Just like Bruce did.
Yeah, but you ain't gonna see Mike didn't have, he didn't have titties and,
but the voice,
and all of that.
He wasn't there yet.
Huh?
He wasn't there yet.
Yeah, but that wasn't his thing, though. See, Mike liked to get high. See, Bruce thing was, he don't do drugs or nothing. He naturally fucking fucked up like that, yo. I think. I mean, who the fuck, what the fuck would make you, I don't know, man. I mean, but Mike wasn't trying to get no sex change and none of that.
You don't know. Maybe he was keeping on the low.
Nah.
Think about his voice.
What?
Talk like Michael used to talk.
Tito. Nigga, I just gave you $2 million last month, nigga. What you doing that?
How did Mike die?
How did Mike die?
Yeah.
Propofol. He was smoking. I mean, he was. See, this is what the doctor said. The doctor said, "Yo, Mike, I finna go downstairs and use the phone." Mike was like, "All right, go ahead. I got this." You know what I mean? Mike like shit. He said, "But Mike, I finna turn the machine on. Whoop whoop. It's gonna put you down and, you know, be cool a little bit." Mike, I got this, motherfucker. I been getting off. I got this. This is the best shit on the plane. You understand? Mike didn't have to. Mike has shit that you take before you go into surgery, nigga. Do you understand? This is before. This is when motherfuckers is outside the surgery room saying, "Okay, we'll be out here when you come out of." He dozing off. That's what he on. You feel me? You gotta understand. Mike said, "I ain't been asleep since the Thriller album." Nigga, head was on fire. It was all type of shit. Mike was fucked up. But the thing is, he was a machine. You feel me? There's a machine out there. It's a refrigerator. All right? That machine got to be running. Whether there's something in that motherfucker or not. Because when you put something in there, if it's running, it ain't going to get cut. It ain't going to work. It's not working like it's supposed to. You get what I'm saying? This is a machine. I have to work 25 hours a day. And it's only 24 in the motherfucker. So you know, where you gonna get some sleep from? Every waking hour, somebody needs something from you. Keep this in mind. You can go nowhere on the planet Earth without knowing who Michael Jackson was. I don't care what language, I don't care. You know what I mean? You probably had a parrot somewhere in Thailand that could say, "Michael Jackson." Because they got them, it's a fan, that's all they listen to is Michael Jackson. So that's all they know is Michael Jackson. They don't speak no other English, but they can tell you everything to Thriller, Off the Wall, Black and White, or any one of them albums. You know, plus Michael's an angel. You know what I mean? That's why he was named after an angel, Michael. So, you know, some people when they leave here, they're going to be... You know, they're going to be trapped between worlds and this and that. Some people is going to be angels. Some people are going to be demons. Some people, it's going to be, you know. So, you know, there is nothing to worry about in that sense. But you never hear, like, people that do shit like Bruce Jenner did. Like, get on stage and say, you know, this is God's plan. This was God. Did you hear God come out of his mouth one time? Not once. I didn't hear, "Thank God, thank God for my family." I didn't hear none of that shit, man. There is a God. I mean, that's for you to dispute, you know what I mean? But anyway, that was some bullshit. This is my opinion. You feel me? He did not have gotten no goddamn Arthur Ashe Award ever. That's another thing they should take back. But that's just a way to just say, "Look, y'all don't mean shit to us." You know what I mean? Like, you mean to tell me a 6-foot man woman is the only person you could have gave that award to? Out of all the courageous, it didn't even have to be a black person. Just because it's Arthur Ashe, I don't think, you know what I mean? It had to be a black, I don't care about that. But could it at least be a real fucking person? Huh? I mean, who does that shit? Straight up, who does that shit? Boy, you SBs, y'all lucky, I swear. As a matter of fact, I'm gonna be on next year at the same time, and I'm coming, SBs, I'm coming for y'all, and I am not gonna forget this shit. The second y'all, I'm going to tell you right now, the second y'all let me on y'all stage, y'all might want to not let me on there. Because the second y'all let me on that stage, I'm going to be just like Kanye was with Mike Myers. George Bush don't like white people. Like, what the fuck is this? What are you talking about? That ain't part of the script. Listen, I don't know what the fuck y'all was doing, man, putting that shit up. They're going to be like, "Cut, go to break." I'm gonna be like, "Yeah, so anyway, they going to give us the goddamn." I don't care, yo. I'm telling you, yo, that's one show. That was the most disrespectful shit you could do to us. You know what I mean? I can see if Arthur Ashe wasn't shit. You feel me? I can see if Arthur Ashe was fucked up some kind of way. You know what I mean? Y'all went up there giving out the goddamn Rick James Award. This is goddamn Arthur Ashe, yo. Come on, man. Got me hot around this joint, yo. Let's go to a break, man. What's the science, man? Shit. The fuck? What is going on with that, man? And then wait, before we go to break. Take you off. Okay. So, before I go to break, yo, what the fuck are y'all doing over there, Cash Money, y'all? Come on, man. Stop that shit. You got Young Thug shooting up tour bus indictments and shit, Birdman throwing drinks on Wayne. You niggas is crazy, man. I got too much money for that shit, man. What's wrong with y'all, man? I don't get it. You know what I mean? Lil Wayne getting money, Birdman getting money, everybody getting money. The shit is just funny to me. You know what I mean? It's just completely funny to me because you used to call him your son. Like, it's your son. Okay? Let's say you decide, oh, okay, I don't want you to be my goddamn son no more. All right? Boom. Okay, that's just it. Let him go. Be. You know what I mean? That's like a person saying, like, to me, like, yo, you know, you don't want the son to be your son no more. You know what I mean? For what? Over a little change, and both of them got money? Both of them got millies? Huh? I'm going to a break.
A millionaire, I'm a young money millionaire, tougher than Nigerian hair. My criteria compared to your career just isn't fair. I'm a venereal disease, like a menstrual bleed through the pencil and leak on the sheet of the tablet in my mind. Cause I don't write shit, cause I ain't got time. For my second minutes, hours go to the almighty dollar in the almighty power of that chopper. Sister, brother, son, daughter, father, motherfucker, copper. Got the Maserati dancing on a bridge, pussy poppin', tell the coppers, ha ha ha, you can't catch them, you can't stop them. I go by them goon rules. If you can't beat them, then you pop them. You can't man them, then you mop them. You can't stand them, then you drop them. You pop them, cause we pop them like Orville Redenbacher. Motherfucker, I'm ill. Yeah, a million here, a million there. Sicilian bitch with long hair, with coconut every gear, like smoking the thinnest air. I open the Lamborghini. Hoping them crackers see me, like, look at that bastard Weezy. He's a beast, he's a dog, he's a motherfucking problem. Okay, you're a goon, but what's a goon to a gobbler? Nothing, nothing, you ain't scaring nothing. On some faggot bullshit, call him Dennis Rodman. Call me with your own peach, call me on my sidekick. Never answer when it's private. Damn, I hate a shy bitch. Don't you hate a shy bitch? Yeah, I hate a shy bitch. She ain't shy no more, she changed her name to my bitch. Yeah, nigga, that's my bitch. So when she asks for the money, when you through, don't be surprised, bitch. And it ain't tricking if you got it. But you like a bitch with no ass, you ain't got shit. Motherfucker, I'm ill, not sick. And I'm okay, but my watch sick. Yeah, my drop sick. Yeah, my clock sick. Am I not thick? I'm ill. Motherfucker, I'm ill. Yeah. See, they say I'm rapping like Big J and Tupac. Andre 3000, where is Erica Badu at? Who that say they gon' beat Lil Wayne? My name ain't Big, but I keep that flame. Like, who that wanna do that? Boy, you knew that you that swallow. And I be this shit, now you got loose bowels. I don't owe you like 2 vowels. But I would like for you to pay me by the hour. And I'd rather be pushing flowers than to be in the pen sharing showers. Tony told us this world was ours, and the Bible told us every girl was sour. Don't flee in a garden and don't smell her flower. Call me Mr. Carter or Mr. Lawnmower. Boy, I got so many bitches like I'm Mike Lowry. Even Gwen Stefani said she couldn't doubt me. Motherfucker, I say life ain't shit without me. Chrome lips poking out the coupe, look like it's pouting. I do what I do and you do what you can do about it. Bitch, I'll turn a crack rock into a mountain. Damn, man, don't you compare me, cause there ain't nobody near me. They don't see me, but they hear me. They don't feel me, but they feel me. I'm ill at C3DP.
Wayne hit Birdman like, hey man, you got my money, man. Birdman, like, how much I owe you, man? He was like, a milli. Yo, what's the science, yo? I am Demega. This is Demega Cole. You are live on the air. We're supposed to be talking about fitness, but we're talking about a bunch of other shit because that's where it started at. Now, we ended off talking about Brucey B from the C. Brucey B from the C. Brucey B from Calabasas. Brucey B from the C, then turned into C from the C. Do you know that he got a TV show now? Kate. I love Kate or some shit.
Yeah. You gonna watch it, bro?
Of course I'm gonna watch this shit. That's my ammunition. Who does this shit? You know what I mean? You got.
So you
gonna
give him money?
No, I ain't gonna give him no goddamn money.
You supporting his movement then?
No, I ain't supporting nothing. I don't support that shit at all.
What you gonna watch?
Because I have to report. I'm a reporter. You feel me? I got to report on the dominance of ignorance that's taking over the society which we perceive. Now, I'm a fitness lawyer. I say this because, now, keep in mind, I'm extremely irritated by this because he was an athlete. See, if he was just a politician or somebody who, you know, wasn't into fitness and all this shit. You know what type of message you're sending out to young men now that's, you know what I mean, that's believing in their athletic? This is what they're going to think now. You know what? If I don't make it in, goddamn it, being a linebacker, I can always get me some titties and ass and just become the next Bruce Jenner. I can become the next Caitlyn. People going to be plotting this shit out right now, yo. It's going to be crazy. It's going to be bananas. Then they legalized all the gay shit. No, I am not with that shit. Not at all. I don't care. And people say, well, you're going to lose a lot of gay fans, and I'm going to lose a lot of gay people with money and all this shit. I can only spend what's entitled to me. You feel me? I'm not salty. Shit, y'all done turned this motherfucker into Sodom and Gomorrah. Shit. God told Lot, wife, don't look back. Keep going. Whoop. She looked back and turned into a pillar of salt. That's the message, y'all. If God tell you to keep going, don't look back. You'd be salty. You'd be salty if you do. All right? Yo, now let's get to fitness. Y'all, because y'all thought that I was here that I ain't going to be talking about fitness. I'm talking about it, y'all. I just was thrown off by this Caitlyn. How much of a platform they gave to that shit. I'm giving it a platform because I'm against it. They gave it a platform because they just want everybody now to just. I wonder how many people in the audience was like, yeah, you know what? I'm going to go home and put on my wife's dress and see if that's really me. Motherfucker, you got 5 kids. Now you decide you want to be a woman? Hey, man. All right, let me get off a dude. Because I'm going to do, like, I'm going to Precious. Remember Precious when I was doing? I didn't kind of calm down on Precious a little bit because I ain't seen her ass nowhere. Thank goodness. You know what I mean? I hope you're breathing. I hope you're alive, Precious. I hope you're doing well in private. You know what I mean? Just stay the fucking private. We don't want to see you no more. We don't want to see you no more on TV. We don't want to see you no more on Empire. We don't want to see you no more. No more, no more, no more. All right? You had your run. You had a good shot. You were good. You were awesome, baby. But we cool on you, all right? Unless you do celebrities, biggest loser or something like that. You feel me? Other than that, I'm really not impressed with shit else you gonna do. Cause all that, oh, I'm fabulous, you haters just keep loving me. I'm on the G4 jet and you know what I mean? Fucking jet gotta use extra fuel and shit for you. Come on, man. Don't get me started. Please don't get me started with her. Gee whiz. All right. Question. Here we go. Families who don't have time to work out, families who don't have time to work out. That's the topic, y'all. Families that don't have time to work out. Why the fuck don't you have time to work out? You know what I mean? Think about it. If you got time to get unhealthy, you got time to work out. Even if you got to divide the time between eating and working out. Yeah, don't play no games with me, man. Thing about it is, if you're serious about something, you'll find ways to really make that happen. You say, well, man, I work 8 hours a day, but you work in a cubicle or you got an office that nobody is in but you. You can work out in your office. You ain't doing nothing else. Everything is hands-on. You can do voice controls, this, that, you know what I mean? Come on. Stop making excuses. Families who don't have time to work out, that's a real simple solution. Make time. Make time. You, if y'all make time to go to the buffet, y'all make time to go to eat on the weekends, you know, turn that into workouts. Turn that into some shit that's productive. You know how to get out of shape. You're an expert at it. Once you become an expert at getting in shape, because at the very least, you're going to help yourself. All right? Now, what tips do you have for busy moms who are trying to stay fit? Busy moms who's trying to stay fit. Pretty much everybody in the gym that's a woman probably got a kid. So I don't, if you're trying to stay fit and you're in the gym, that's cool. If you're trying to stay fit and you're working out at home, that's fine. I don't get the question in here, you know what I mean? What tips do you have for busy moms who are trying to stay fit? Are you unfit? Do you want to be more fit? Are you out of shape? I mean, I don't get it, because if you're a mom, you're just a mom. You know what I mean? You got to figure that in with just like every other thing that you figure in with the kid. You know what I mean? It's like you figure in you got to go to work. Okay, you got to drop them off here. You figure you got to go to do this or take care of that or pay these bills. Do whatever you got to do. You got a way to do something with the kid. You got to do that the same way with the workout. It's just, it's only time. Gee whiz, y'all. All right? Make your health a priority. It's very easy to slip into a mommy-daddy mode where you take care of everyone else but forget about yourself. Build fitness time each day. That's all I said. That's all. You can do every 10-minute segments, right? 10-minute segments, 20 minutes, whatever. Baby take a nap. And then again, you talk about what type of mom. You know what I mean? If your kid is 15 and you're just talking about you got to pick him up from school, then, you know, then that don't, you got all day to figure out how to work out. But if you got a little baby and you're trying to get back in shape, or you got a, you know, 1-2-year-old and you got to roll with you, you got to figure it out because you're smart. You're smart enough to have a baby. All right. How do you juggle fitness with parenting? How do you juggle fitness with parenting? I just said that, didn't I? All right. Let's go to the next question. Are there any types of exercise that are proven most effective to mom's or dad's busy schedule? Now, we're talking about family fitness now, yeah. The whole family. Are there any types of exercises that are proven most effective to mom's or dad's busy schedule? Proven most effective. Depends on what you're trying to do. You know what I mean? If you're trying to lose weight, if you're trying to build muscle, I mean, it depends on what you're trying to do when it depends on what type of exercises, yeah? Yeah. I don't get this question. Okay. But this got to do with family. All right. Family's number one. How much are your results worth? How much are your results worth? Depends on you. Do you want to go to the beach with your shirt off, or do you just want to go to the beach? Yeah, you went from, I don't even want to go to the beach, to I just want to go to the beach, to I want to go to the beach, to I want to go to the beach with the shirt off, to let's keep going to the beach. You got, you know, it's just different levels, right? What is it worth to you? Fellas, if you take off your clothes and you're looking at yourself and you're like, yo, I don't like how I look. You know what I mean? Keep in mind, there's going to be a woman that you're going to try to love or impress or whatever is going to think the same way. She don't like how you look. So it's, you know, if you're going to lose weight, and I'm talking to obese people here, you know, obese people kind of stay in their lane when it comes to like dating and things like that, because, or they got this social media shit. Social media knock 20, 30, 40, 50, 100 pounds off of you without you even, you know, because you remember they got that one picture. There she is. That's it right there. Just that part right there. So that don't look fat. You feel me? And after a month or so of just going back and forth for that, back and forth for that, a person is just getting bigger and fatter because they're getting fed more bullshit. And then when a person finally meets, it's like, whoa! Janet Jackson had getting a little too... Don't you ever come around here ever again. On Friday, I'm telling you. It is Friday too, huh? That was the funniest shit, man. Friday was the funniest movie. Yo. That was the original Friday. When it came out, I laughed so hard. I laughed so hard, man. I mean, from the time it came on to the time it went off, that was some funny shit. We ain't gonna get no more like that. Nah, we ain't gonna get no more like that. We ain't gonna get no more like that. The pinky one was funny, dude. The pinky one was funny. Almost made me spill my yak on this $200 suit. That was a funny one. You know what I mean? But that original Friday? Ah, I met Debo. That is huge, man. You ever met Debo? This motherfucker is big, man.
I met Pinky.
Yeah, I met Pinky. I know Cliff and Ollie. Yeah, yeah. But Debo was a big nigga, man. Mm-hmm. So, but I met Cube, though. I'm thinking it's a little shorter, though. Okay, let's get back to the thing, man. We go off into all types of shit on this show, yo. I love it. That's why it's the hottest show on fitness, because I'm going to tell you how to get in shape, and I'm going to tell you a bunch of other shit, too. You know what I'm saying? Because a lot of being in shape is, being out of shape is what you intake and what you put out. You feel me? I love the smell of fresh ambition in the morning. You know what I mean? So, let me tell you some of the topics that I'm going to talk about right now. Right, pertaining to fitness. Yo, what the fuck are y'all talking about? Talking about Serena is shaped like a man, yo. I had to get my baby powder out. Straight up. And just, where is she shaped like a man at? Did you see the pictures? You didn't see the pictures. Mm-hmm. Let me show you the pictures, y'all. You tell me where she's shaped like a man at, yo. Anywhere on the planet Earth. Here you go. You be the judge of that. All right? What man you know is shaped like that? Show the people. What man do they know? Let me see. Can you see? What man do you know is shaped like this, yo? Let me put it over here. Can you see? Oh, it's up there. What man you know is shaped like that? Don't worry. I'll wait. Yeah, no. I tell you what, I bet you Caitlyn ain't shaped like that. And that's a man. The fuck? If y'all don't knock it off with the shit, I'm for real, yo. I mean, can we get some type of credit? That's why, you know what I mean, when you uncensored and you can say what you want, some people say, you know, you just have to be, I don't have to be shit. Straight up. Because you know what? Like I said, I'm anointed to do it, so I'm appointed to do it. And look at this. Now, check this out. This is Samantha. You know who this is? Samantha Suto. Suto. Shit. Hit the screen. Hit the screen. Let me show you. Her name is Samantha Stusor. I guess. Stosur. She played tennis. She played against Serena. That's her. All right? And they got the nerve to say something about Serena? This is her. Come on, man. Knock the fuck off. For real. If y'all ain't got nothing else to do, just knock it the fuck off, man. How many Wimbledon she got? Four? She got how many damn champions? How many? Just say I hate. Just say we the haters. Just start your conversation like that. We the haters think Serena, you know, and then just go on from there. I mean, because Stevie Wonder can see that, you know what I mean, Serena. I just didn't like that, you know what I mean? Don't give me no. All right. Florida, this is something, I'm going to do some of my hot topics. These are my hot topics, yo. Florida church sends $1,000 collection notice to single mother for failure to pay her tithes. Let me say that again, yo, because at first I said, what the fuck? Then I laughed. Then I said, wait a minute. Then I laughed. Then I thought, now, wait a minute. Who does this? Florida church sends $1,000 collection notice to a single mother for failure to pay tithes. Who did that? Was God in charge of that? I owe you $1,000 because I couldn't pay you $25? Who? What you think about that, huh? Who does that, though? I mean, what the fuck? What kind of church is this, yo? Who's the pastor? Bishop Eddie Long? Huh? Dick Tracy? This old fucking sick motherfucker. Boy, I swear, man, don't get me started with this, though. Think about this for a second. How do you send a person $1,000? Put you now, I'm going into collections because I couldn't give you $50. And then you want me to come and worship and pray and worship with you and almighty valid woman of God, this and that. And how do you do that? Huh? But how do you go to that church? What church? How do you go to that church and say, yo, you know y'all sent me $1,000 bill this Friday. It's Sunday now, right? I'm going to church on Sunday, yo. You sent me $1,000 bill. You put I owe y'all $1,000 because I didn't pay y'all time. Oh, yeah, well, just pray about it. Pray about it? What the fuck you mean? Like, listen, man. This is the thing, man. If you're a child of God and you're anointed, you're not a fool. And if you are, it's because you choose to be. All right? It's common sense right there. I just had to say that one because that's corny to me. All right? Are you a Lakers fan? Who is number 22 on the Lakers? Who?
Right now?
No. What you mean right now? It's just Lakers number is retired, so it ain't no right now. Who's number 22 that played for the Lakers?
Is it Elgin Baylor?
There it is. That's who it is. Here's the team right here. Who's your team? Lakers or the... Huh?
Lakers.
Here's the teams, y'all. Here we go. Here's the squad. Wait, let me see. There it is. Who y'all got?
D Rose in there.
Here's the squad. I gotta go with the Lakers, man. I would take the Bulls if Jordan had a center. I can't do it with Grant. Not over Kareem, the skyhook. That motherfucker never missed that skyhook, yo. Ever. He used to frustrate the shit out of people. Like, man, I can't get to that skyhook. Here's the Laker team. Magic, Kobe, Elgin Baylor, Shaq, and Kareem. Shaq at power forward, Kareem at center. Magic at point, Kobe at off guard, and Elgin at the forward. That'd be a hard team to beat. But here goes Chicago. Derrick Rose, no, too hurt too much. Mm-hmm. Hurt too much. He gonna start crying soon as Shaq give him an elbow. Mm-hmm. He couldn't have played with Shaq. Yeah, Derrick Rose, Michael Jordan, you know Mike all the time. You know he gonna get his 60, 70. You know what I mean? But I don't know against Magic and Kobe and Shaq and Kareem. Woo! Mike might have been. He would have been. They might have held Mike to like 10 points a game. But you got D Rose, Mike. Scottie Pippen, he would have been a non-factor. Dennis Rodman, I don't know what the fuck the worm would have did. He would have just frustrated you. He'd have did his part. He ain't gonna score you no goddamn points, but he'd make you mad as a motherfucker.
Then
This motherfucker used to pull up to the game. This motherfucker used to pull up to the games, yo, in on a motorcycle with a fucking wedding dress on. Who? And back then it was like AC Green. I mean, it was like Dennis Rodman was the weirdest dude in the NBA, but I thought it was AC Green.
Why? What did he do?
Because he was a grown ass man in the NBA, and he you know, he never had no pussy. I didn't understand that. You know what I mean? He was like 30 something.
Why didn't he get none?
He said he's waiting until he's married. I mean, that's cool. I just thought it was fucking weird. You know what I mean? I think, you know, if that's what you're going to do, if you're going to be a priest or something. But, you know, like, fuck am I? You know what I mean? Dennis Rodman came to the thing with Brian, you know what I mean? And then you got Horace Grant. Horace was cool. But I couldn't see him against Shaq or Kareem or even Elgin. Shit. So now I'm gonna take the Lakers over that right there. All right. Okay. Now we're talking about some of the things that I posted. All right. 10 quotes from the great Indian chief Standing Bear. So we gotta give, you know, shout out to all my Native American fans, y'all. You know, we gotta give y'all some credit, you know what I mean? Cause y'all was here. You know what I mean? Y'all was here. I don't know why y'all ain't come up with the gun. Because when they came with them pistols and shit, they did this the same way over in Africa. You know what I mean? They came with them guns, y'all. And we had bows and arrows and shit. And they like, oh, nah, y'all got to get close up on us to make that shit effective. We can hit y'all from right here. Boom. And they just start racking up. All right? But here go some of the things that were said. Praise, flattery, exaggerated manners, and fine, high-sounding words were no part for Lakota. Is that where they're from? Mm-hmm. Lakota politeness? Fine actions rather than words. Yeah. All right, we'll get back to that one. All right. Coconut oil, y'all. Y'all drinking coconut? Coconut oil kills 90% of colon cancer. Did y'all know that? Coconut oil kills 93% of colon cancer. Colon cancer cells. Did y'all know that? If y'all didn't know that, now you know. All right? I just told you that. Did it out of love, so y'all don't owe me shit. Here's one for you, y'all. I know this ain't got nothing to do with fitness, but here we go. Another way of how we got duped out of some money because you don't know your worth. You got to know your worth, y'all. Listen, let me tell you something. Let me put it down for a second. Worth. You got to know your worth, y'all. If you don't know your worth, you don't know what you're working for. You don't know what you're designed for. You don't know what you don't know what you can get back. You're just putting out. I mean, know your worth. Know your energy. All right? Trust me, you are worth something. Now, it's up to you to figure out your worth. Accelerate your fat metabolism. All right. Five foods. Wait a minute. I was talking about something else. How did I get on? He was talking about worth. Shit. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'll get back to that. Anyway, let's talk about five fat-burning foods to boost your metabolism. Number one, brown rice. You got that? Brown rice, y'all, it boosts your metabolism. All right. Egg whites. Egg whites are good. Keep you shredded. Of course, chicken breast. All right. Chicken breast is a lean meat. Lean meats are full of iron. Eating about 3 or 4 servings of iron-filled foods will help you avoid an iron deficiency, which can cause your metabolism to slow down. Chicken has little fat and a lot of protein. If you're trying to add bulk to your muscles, grilled chicken can help. Stressed, eat chicken. Chicken contains vitamin B5, which has a calming effect in the nerves. I don't know how that happens, but that's just what the fuck it says. So eat some chicken, y'all. Chicken breast, all right? Chili peppers. I don't really like chili peppers because I don't like hot stuff. You know what I mean? But if it's not that hot, it's all right. But I'm just telling you, this is some good stuff that boosts your metabolism. Chili peppers contain capsaicin. Wait. Capsaicin. I'ma spell it, you pronounce the shit. Capsaicin. A chemical compound that can kick metabolism into a higher gear, says Scott Isaacs, MD, clinical instructor at the medical of Emory University School of Medicine. It also helps minimize food glucose and cholesterol levels, lowers high blood pressure, and triggers the release of endorphins, brain chemicals that counteract the depression and mood swings. This is all that happens when you eat chili pepper, y'all. Your shit. You can be less depressed and you can watch your mood swings. If you don't know, now you know. And of course, lastly, the five fat burning for to boost your metabolism, water. Good old water. I drink alkaline water. Of course. Alkaline water. You have to drink alkaline water, all right? Here's the thing. Lastly, do not forget mainly hydrated. A study published by the Journal of Clinical and Metabolism showed that the consumption of water can increase the metabolic rate by 30% in healthy men and women. Drinking a healthy amount of water helps the body fluid balance. Now, keep in mind, I'm talking about alkaline water. This is like kryptonite, y'all. You know what I mean? Because it has 80% more oxygen in it than regular water. All right. You see this? Look at that. Woo!
She ain't got no legs.
She ain't got no legs. But this is on. Now. She had no legs. Amy. Trudy, they should look her up. Y'all should look her up. She's really dope. She's an athlete. I don't know what happened to her leg, but her study, the story is pretty deep. Amy Purdy. That's P-U-R-D-Y. Amy. Google her, y'all. She's dope. I don't care if your appearance is a 10, if your personality is a 3, then you're a 3. That's what I posted. I don't know, y'all. Ladies, if your boyfriend wears skinny jeans, you're a lesbian. All right. There's 7 days in the week, and some day isn't one of them. 7 days in a week, and someday isn't one of them. All right. Note to self, go harder. That's note to self. Well, of course, you've seen that. Oh, you see this? Did you see that? Shit, that's dope, man.
You hear about Chris Brown?
Chris Breezy! Look at me now. Oh, I'm getting paper. Breezy, what up, man? What's the science, yo? Breezy, he out here, he partying, man. He a rock star. You know what I mean? Gotta be careful out here, rock stars. You know what I mean? Because the less you associate with people that you're not doing business with, the better. You know what I mean? When you reach a certain level, you know what I mean? I'm just saying, you know, that's cold right there, you know. How do people know to know where you are and how they do, you know, that's inside, you know what I mean? But he said he got more problems than the president, he said. You know what I mean? It's a light, you know what I mean? You attract what you know. Kid Rock. He said he rocking with the Confederate flag. Mm-hmm. I heard.
with that. He rocking with that, the Confederate flags. Fashion trend might cause nerves damage. Tight skinny jeans, health risk. Fellas, tight skinny jeans is a health risk. It could cause nerve damage. Hey, man, don't shoot the messenger, yo. It's right here. You see that? All right. Okay. Social media people. Stop being offended by Facebook posts, by a piece of art, by people displaying affection. You should be more offended by war, poverty, injustice, and greed. Stop being so offended by everything, yo. You know what I mean? Especially if you don't have the goddamn solution. All right? You just so, you know, working on the problem. You so focused on the problem. Okay, we are not human beings having a spiritual experience. We're spiritual beings having a human experience. You believe in ghosts?
I don't know.
I seen one. Actually, I seen two, but I've seen one. I don't know.
I don't know.
I might have been smoking too much kush or something. Mm-hmm. But the second one, I'm telling you, yo. So there is an unseen world, you know what I mean? Straight up. You said you have or you haven't?
I haven't seen one.
Do you believe?
No comment.
Okay, because you don't want to get home and Casper be sitting up like, yeah, remember you said, you know we everywhere. Well, you know, we all got guardian angels, yo. You know what I mean? Especially if you're a child of God, you got an angel around you at all times, protecting you at all times. Did you know that? Then you also can commission other angels to go and do things for you that is, you know, it's part of the purpose. People don't realize that. They think that they don't have angels that they can commission and go. I mean, I'm telling you, it's deep, yo. See, stop giving CPR to dead situations. Oh, that's a good one. Stop giving CPR to dead situations, yo. If it's dead, let it be dead. You know what I mean? Stop bringing it back to life, yo. All right? They can't even get on their own feet but can't stand you. Ooh, that's a good one. Hey, suicide. People, listen, don't kill yourself. If you're obese, if you're overweight, don't kill yourself, all right? Keep living and eventually you'll get better. You know what I mean? Time heals all wounds. Remember, suicide doesn't take away the pain. It gives it to someone else. All right? So if you think that you're going to take away the whatever traumatic pain that you're going through by killing yourself, it doesn't. You give it to way more people than just yourself. All right? Understand this. It's a science to this show. All right? My show, my words. Do we got to go to a break? Mm-hmm. Come on. Okay. We got... You say yeah? Take me off. I know that's real, 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 real. That's like real. That's like ancient to you. But it's a reality, you know what I mean? This is the reality there. Summertime. This is the summertime, and we notice that people get a little more amped, you know, in the summertime. This is a message to the shooters, all of the shooters. This is, dear shooters, you know, let us enjoy our summers. If you're going to shoot, shoot yourself. We want to live. Sincerely, everybody. All right? Especially in the ghetto.
Talking about the ghetto. Funky, funky ghetto. Trying to survive.
trying to stay alive.
Yo, what's the science? Yo, I am Demega. This is Demega Coat. You're live on the air. We talking about fitness, but we talking about a whole bunch of other stuff too, man. And I'm loving it. You know why? Because it keeps everybody in tune with everything. Period. All right? And you got to keep in mind now, Fitness means no weakness, nowhere. Period. That means not mentally, not spiritually, not physically, not creatively, not with your energy. I mean, you have to be on point. Baby. And let's hope that it points to the sky. Keep your head to the sky, y'all. All right. Now, let's get back to what we was talking about. And what we was talking about is Precious. Nah, I'm just playing. Precious. She all right. I just don't fuck with her like that, no. All right. And now we're going to talk about, here's another thing, y'all. A lot of times, I talk about the obesity side of fitness, but for a couple of minutes, I'm gonna talk about the learning side of fitness. All right, let me put y'all up on something real quick. All right, let me put y'all up on the 10 highest paid personal trainers. I don't know how I'm not on this list, because I don't even know most of these cats, yo. You know what I mean? For real. But I'm going to shoot some names out there because I ain't no hater and I want everybody to get their recognition. And you tell me if you know. Harley Packersnack. Harley Packersnack. Pasternak. There you go. Couldn't see it. Shit. Harley Pasternak. Personal trainer for Lady Gaga, Alicia Keys, Jessica Simpson, Orlando Bloom, Halle Berry, Jimmy Fallon, and Miley Cyrus. Okay. Lou Ferrigno. Of course we know who Money Lou is. That was Michael Jackson trainer right there. You feel me? Money Mike right there, man. Man, rest in peace, Mike. I don't care what they say, but Mike was a bad motherfucker. Every time I say Mike, I'm gonna say that I'm gonna say your name with the greatest recognition, Mike. Cause you did a lot for people. You were a great humanitarian. You feel me? Now what if they came out and gave Caitlyn Jenner the Michael Jackson Lifetime Achievement Award? That would have just really been just...
I'm just saying it would have made more sense than the Arthur Ashe one.
So you're saying it would have made more sense to give him a Michael Jackson Award than an Arthur Ashe? That's a bigger slap in the face than Arthur Ashe!
He looked like Mike.
Huh?
He looked like Mike.
Oh, my God. He don't look like no goddamn Mike, man. Even though Mike...
You
can
give me your heart.
I am speaking from my heart, yo. Cause I remember the Mike with the nose. And then I remember, I'm a Mike fan. I mean, Ben, I'm that Mike fan. You feel me? I'm it's a dance machine. Oh, babe. I'm that Mike. I'm the Wiz. I'm the East on down the road, Mike. Huh?
So you're the one before Caitlyn, then? Before he turned into Caitlyn.
He said Mike turned into Caitlyn. Mike didn't turn into Caitlyn, man. Mike turned into Mike. He evolved, man. He had the shit. He had the vitiligo, man. I'm telling you.
That's what Bruce Jenner.
He didn't have none of that shit, man. I think it's a stunt, man. I think there's just some tissue or something there. I don't think them is real tits. He didn't have no cleavage. You see what I mean? I mean, you get up there with a dress on, and come on, man. Where's the voice hormones at? If you turn it into Mike, you feel me? Mike can hit notes. When Mike got up there and talked, you knew this is Michael Jackson. You know what I mean? Dude get up there and talk, it's like... Shit, I forgot I was walking down, Santa Monica and Santa Monica and La Brea somewhere over there by the donuts. You know what I mean? Gee whiz, this is crazy. What do you say? What do you do? And then, who was the cat that made them, I just posted this dude too. He was hot. I think he was an amputee. He's an amputee, and he said something about it. I don't know what it is. Okay, let's go back to these personal trainers real quick, because we only got a few more. We got Bob Green, who was Oprah's trainer. All right, remember she moved him in? Remember? That was Oprah. She lost all that weight, remember? That was like years ago. You wasn't even born then, man. That was like a long time ago. That's when they used to call it a bobblehead Oprah, because she had lost all the weight, but her head still. She used to. All right, David Bauer, personal trainer for LL Cool J, Leonardo DiCaprio, Joey Lawrence, Tyler Perry. Tyler Perry. All right. Is he in shape? I guess you can just, yeah, you put a name to it, you know what I mean? You really ain't got to be in shape. LL's a good example, though. Who else? Mark Jenkins, personal trainer for... Hold on. Personal trainer for Diddy, Mary J. Blige, Beyonce, Busta Rhymes, Missy Elliott. I like Missy. Joe D'Angelo, personal trainer for nobody. Just some magazines. All right, that's cool. Michael George, personal trainer for Reese Witherspoon, Julian Moore, Meg Ryan, Christian Slater, Selma Ward, Dennis Quaid. Michael George. Not George Michael, y'all. Michael George. Although they look like they could, you know, be the same. Look, if you get my drift. Tracy Anderson. Of course, we know Tracy. I know Tracy Anderson. She's pretty good. She got it going on. She do Madonna, Gwyneth Paltrow, and that's it. I guess that's all you need. Shit, Madonna than Gwyneth Paltrow. That'll take care of that. That'll send you into retirement. You know what I mean? Bernardo Capalopa. Hope I said it right, dude. If I didn't, so what you gonna do about it? You're a little guy. I ain't scared of you. Just kidding, man. Capper DeBarno Capitolo. Anyway, I don't know how to say pronounce your name, but when I tell you who you train, then that's how they'll know you anyway. You know what I mean? Like, who the shit cares? Mariah Carey. Okay. Okay. Mariah Carey. I like Mariah, man. She's all right. She just ain't, you know, her elevator don't go all the way up. You know what I mean? I mean, the lights is on. You see people moving around. It just ain't nobody home, though. So she lost 70 pounds with him, though. All right, that's cool. He trained Matthew Morrison, whoever that is, Jane Lynch, whoever that is, Ryan Murphy, whoever that is. I guess that's the other side of Hollywood. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know Jane Lynch.
Who?
Jane Lynch, the white woman.
The white one?
Tall, lesbian chick.
Huh? I don't know her. What? Who she play for? What she do?
She was in Glee. She's always the gay one. I don't know.
In Glee? Man, I ain't never seen one episode of Glee in my life, y'all. Yeah. Glee, what do they do on Glee? That's like the white empire, right? Yeah, okay. All right. Shout out to Empire. When they coming back, yo? Come on back, Empire. Just leave Precious out. Leave her out. Don't bring her back, yo. I'm telling you. Lee Daniels, I done told you now. Leave her the fuck out of there, yo. Who? Where? That's her? I don't know her, man. I ain't never seen her before in my life.
You only watch black shows.
Yeah, I only watch black shows. Sorry.
And Caitlin.
Caitlin. They finna give her a show, man. I'm only gonna watch one show just so I can have enough ammo to say what the fuck. I'm already gonna say what the fuck because I already said what the fuck. You know what I mean? So that's just what it is. Alright. You know.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Let me see. So that was that. Damn, I gotta go. Huh? Oh yeah, my this is cool session. So look. Well, hold on, y'all. Hold on.
This is cool.
Oh, pow! Hey! Yo, this is my this is cool session, y'all. Before I get out of here. You know what I thought was cool? You know what I thought was cool? Obama. Even though you ain't shit when it comes to this stuff, when it comes to the one about the gay marriage and all, you flipped on it. You let a bunch of people out of jail that wasn't supposed to be there. He let out four times the amount of people He let out more people than the last four presidents together. Exonerated them. Get out. You did some time? Go ahead. You was doing, you been here since what? 80 what? 90 what? And you only had what? Two bags of weed? What? Well, why they got you in here? Because of my name. Because who they say I am. Who they say I would do. You need to let Larry Hoover out. And, Abu-Jamal should let him out, too. Mamoui Abu-Jamal should let him out. Who else? Oh, and rest in peace to Gaddafi, the young brother who's with the Outlaws. He died in a car accident. Rest in peace. I met them, the Outlaws. That was Tupac group. That was Tupac's little brother who was by another father and all that. Anyway, so rest in peace to them. Anyway. This is cool. I thought that Obama letting them cats out of jail was the coolest thing ever on the planet. And they said he's still not done because it's people that's in there that, I mean, over some bullshit, man. Free my man Rodney O. All right? Free my man Rodney Scioto. I love you, dog. Peace, one love. Listen, whatever you do, from the bad to the worst, keep God first, all right? Get closer to your dreams.
I'm getting high.